What's up, guys? It's Charles here with Rocket Punch Army to do a review of the Transformers Age of Extinction Hotshot Deluxe figure. We're taking a look at the box. It's empty. He's not in there because I got him ready for the review. It's got nice artwork right up here showing off his red face and white helmet with the little visor things there. And the bottom here shows the actual toy in vehicle mode. If we turn it around, it's the usual stuff back here, robot mode, his alternate mode. Also available figures, and his little bio. So I'll zoom in if you guys want to read that right up here. And now we'll continue on along. And here he is in vehicle mode. It's a beautiful looking Corvette, the new model. Although with very little detail here in the rear, there's no taillights painted on. Even the exhaust tips are the same blue plastic. The diffuser is painted the same color as the car. I believe they're black. But overall, very nice. The headlights are painted underneath this clear plastic. The grill opening is painted black, and you've got a very nice Tempo printed Autobot logo right on the hood. It's kind of hard to see, but this actually does have a metallic paint on it, which is kind of weird since most Hasbro toys don't have any kind of full-blown paint on here, but it seems like they have sprayed the entire car. Although looking at the bottom blue here, even though it does have little metallic flakes, it looks like it's just in the plastic and not actually painted on. You get some nice dark tinted windows. You get a nice spoiler back here, which is molded in a gun metallic gray. And then the rims here are nicely detailed, but there's no paint apps on them, which is a shame. I'd like to see, you know, the rim silver or something underneath. Yeah, guys, this is pretty much a shell former, if you'd like. If you guys have crosshairs, it's pretty much the same exact thing. For those of you that don't, this is what to expect. It's pretty much a robot already laying inside. This kind of reminds me of those little matchbox size Transformers they made, the RPMs or whatever they were called. When you would look underneath, there's a robot. This kind of reminds me of it because the robot's pretty much there. Going to do a little size comparison with another figure. Believe it or not, this is a Voyager figure compared to it, so it's way out of scale. And just for fun, I'll throw in a little Generations Deluxe here, RC. As you can see, she is dwarfed by Hotshot. Now, Hotshot does come with weapons. He's got these two little weapons which do attach to the side of the door panels here, but near impossible to have in there and transform. If you guys saw reviews on Crosshairs, a big pain in the butt to transform this guy. This is no exception. It's the same pain in the butt. But the other gun does go right under here, tabs in one of these holes. You can put it in either side. So now that we've checked out alternate mode, let's go ahead and put him into robot mode. First thing you want to do is take out the gun. All right, so here's Hotshot in robot mode. All right, like I said, there's little weapons. This is my favorite one. This one can actually just attach here, right? And then you get two of the other smaller ones, which you can also attach in his hand, or you can use the two smaller ones however you'd like. You can also store the two small ones. It's kind of hard to see, but it's right in here. If I can just get this to stay open, there's a little round thing right there. You can actually just pop that right in there. Right, so you can store it in robot mode. Do a little bit of scaling here, but it's really hard to handle this guy and not think of this guy. I hope Repro Labels does something with this guy to make it look like Trax. I'd like it to be a Trax instead of a Hotshot. I mean, it's just such a striking similarity, it's almost too obvious. And here he is with Evasion Mode Voyager Prime. Here we have Voyager Hound, Deluxe Lockdown, and Deluxe Snarl. And next to some masterpiece figures. So next we're going to check out some articulation on this guy. You got the head, which just moves back and forth. It's kind of limited by these things on the side of the head. You got the shoulders here. You do have the bicep swivel. You have a double jointed elbow, which is pretty good. You have the wrists, which move up and down, but there's really not. I wish it was a ball joint actually, and maybe this panel could fold down. You don't get a waist, but you do get the hips, legs forward and back. You get the knee here, and the feet just tilt this way here. Overall, robot mode's pretty good. It's a little bit of an awkward figure, but it's not too bad. It's got a real nice Autobot Tempo print there, but that's pretty much it, guys, for this review here. Pretty simple review, pretty simple figure, but I think it really looks nice on display with all your other figures. If you have any questions or comments, leave them below. If you want to pick this guy up, head over to the link in the description and you can pick him up there. And until next time, guys, bye-bye.